So the only difference between the simple altimeter and the static, sorry, sensitive altimeter is, do you see these capsules? These capsules are aneroid wafers which are made big and they are arranged in series. Am I clear? Correct. That is the only change. Now, this is used in Cessna 172, but lag error is still there. Correct. Because this does not solve the problem. Anyway, they have to move all the linkages gears physically. Correct. Now, can this be used in an aircraft like A320, which climbs very fast? No. Correct. So, in all other aircrafts which need very accurate measurements of altitude, they use something called a servo-assisted altimeter. Correct. Now, let's see what is servo-assisted altimeter. This is a bit complex. Okay. What I'll do, I'll draw my own diagram. See, in any altimeter, the principle is same. That is decrease in height with, but decrease in pressure with height. Correct. So that should be measured by capsule only. Correct. So in this altimeter also, there are capsules. Let's say these are capsules. They are multiple and they are arranged in series as if they are as in sensitive altimeter. Okay. Now, there is something called as I bar. And there is something called as E bar. This is an I bar and this is an E bar. Here, what is I bar? I bar is a magnet. What is E bar? E bar is supplied with wires like this. Clear? E bar is called as electro magnetic induction pickup device, or simply called as pickup device. How many of you are very good with your plus 12 physics? Or if you take a wire like this, this is ammeter. That means it will measure current. Okay. This is just a wire. And what happens if you put a magnet like this and keep on rotating the magnet like this? What happens to the ammeter? See, magnet has lines of flux around it, correct? Magnet has something called as lines of flux around it. Now, when the magnet is rotated, the lines of flux will cut differently every second. Correct. So that will generate a potential difference between the two terminals, and this circuit will have current in it. That is detected by ammeter. You would have read all these things in your lower classes, correct? Am I clear? So change in electromagnetic flux will induce voltage. Correct. So, if there is a change in electromagnetic flux, there's a change in flux, it will induce voltage. Now, how much is the voltage induced? Voltage induced is proportional to the rate of change of flux. Am I clear? So, more the change of flux, more will be the voltage induced. How many of you understood till here? This simple experiment from your lower classes, is it understood? Varun, Darwin, raise your hands. Good. Yes. Now see, for these wires are connected to an amplifier. These are connected to an amplifier. Now, this amplifier is connected to a motor. Motor will rotate the pointers. Okay, so this is 100 needle, this is 1000 needle, this is 10,000 needle. Now what happens is, for example, aircraft starts going up. What happens to the Android capsules? See, this is held by leaf spring like this, correct? Now, as the aircraft going up, goes up, the static pressure outside the capsule decreases.
Capsule compress.
Correct? The capsule expands.
Yeah, expands.
Correct? So, here also, the capsule expands. Do you see, when the capsule expands, it is connected to I bar. Even a small micrometer expansion of the capsule will move this magnet. I bar is a magnet. Now that small movement will cause a change in flux, magnetic lines of flux in this E bar. Correct. That E bar will detect the small change in current, and that will amplify the current and it will send to motor. That small change is shown on the screen. Correct, on the altimeter. Am I clear? So, lag error is virtually eliminated. Lag error is virtually eliminated by using servo assisted altimeter.
Sir, can you explain once, please?
Which one? Which point? Total?
Yeah.
See, the capsule is connected to I bar only. Okay. Now,
right.
As the aircraft from the ground starts going up. Okay.
Right.
What happens? This is the aneroid capsule. Correct.
Right.
That is a partially evacuated, there is vacuum, but that is kept open by whatever datum you have set. Correct. If, for example, at the ground the pressure is 1000, this spring will keep the capsule open as if the inside pressure is 1000.
Yes.
Correct. Outside the capsule, it is exposed to environment. So because it is 1000 near ground, it also will be 1000.
Right.
Now, as the aircraft climbs like this, correct, outside pressure decreases, but inside you have set as 1000.
Yes.
Correct. So this will become 998, so on and so forth. And that means it will decrease. When outside pressure decreases and inside is 1000, the capsule will start expanding.
Yeah.
When it expands, it will push the I bar. That small push, even it is in micro millimeters, okay, that will lead to some rate of change of flux. Some change of flux in the E bar. E bar picks up that small current and gives it to amplifier. Amplifier increases the current. Correct. It will increase the current proportionately, and it will send to a motor, and motor will rotate the pointers.
Okay.
Am I clear? Am I super clear on this?
Yes,
here in this altimeter, okay, see, between capsule and I bar there can be some kind of friction also, correct? For example, you take your phone and keep it on the desk. Okay. See, the desk is not exactly straight, but it is kind of slope. Always, it cannot be very perfectly straight, correct? But your phone does not slip away. Why? Because there is friction between the desk and the phone. Understood? But what happens when it vibrates? It will start slipping away. Correct? Have you noticed that if you keep the phone, when it is vibrating, it will start slowly moving?
Yes.
Correct? So that means friction, vibration will decrease the friction. Correct? So that's why there is a device in every altimeter to decrease the friction. That is called as vibrator. Okay, that is called as vibrator. Vibrator is also called as knocking device. This is used to decrease friction. How many of you understood?
Decrease the friction where? Decrease the friction where?
Between any parts in the altimeter. Okay, between all parts in altimeter. Next. There is also called one more part called as jeweled bearings. Jeweled bearings are parts which are arranged in like as if you are wearing a necklace. Correct. These are also used to decrease friction. But what I'll do in magnetism, correct, in the next chapter, which we will discuss, I'll explain this in detail regarding jeweled bearings. So as of today, there are two devices which are used to decrease friction. One is a vibrator or knocking device, and the next is jeweled bearings. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.